Hey! Hi, I'm Kelly Hawkins, founder of The Daily Rally.
Already interviewed Chesson, so we're rolling.
Well, you started off on a high note.
Yes, he was great.
Everything's gonna be downhill from here.
So I sat down with professional golfer Blayne Barber to find out everything that goes into playing golf besides actually playing golf. So I'm going beyond the links to find out more. So to start things off, when did you start playing golf? And how did you view playing golf? Was it just kind of a fun thing that you were doing after school, or was it something that you went, I want to be a professional golfer from day one?
The goal was always to be a professional golfer. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's been a fun journey, and I've always really dreamt of doing this, and it's a blessing to do what I love.
How did you have that discipline to just go out there and bang balls and get really good?
I have no idea. I think you either have to be completely type A and organized, which is my personality.
Yeah.
Or you have to just really enjoy it and like just be a player and kind of go out and mm-hmm. just goof off with it, right? I've always kind of had an entrepreneurial type bent, and so being a golfer, I mean, I'm running my own business and doing my own thing, so it's something that I've always liked from that aspect of it too. There's a lot that goes into playing golf other than just hitting balls in the range.
Did you realize how much went into the business of being a golfer? Because it is an entrepreneurial
yeah.
sort of gig, because
yeah.
the sponsors, the team you have to build, the agent. What was your understanding of that?
You don't know what you're getting into until you start doing it, I guess. It just kind of builds upon itself. Like it was me and my wife, we were newly married. She caddied for me a lot. We just went out, I'm just trying to make a living so we can survive. And then I think you kind of just almost get like baptized by fire. Like you just,
yeah.
you figure it out.
When you're talking about networking and working with different sponsors, what has that experience been like?
I think it's really important to treat everyone with respect and treat everyone kindly, because you never know when an opportunity is going to present itself.
Who is your person that you go to when you need to either be shot straight or for emotional support? Who is that person that you know you can go to?
Thankfully for me, it's my wife. She's very even-keeled. She's not, you know, rocked by good days, bad days. She's just kind of like their constant source of support. Yeah, very thankful for Morgan.
How did becoming a father change your perspective on everything you're doing out here?
If you want to invest in your family and your kids and your wife, like it takes so much time and energy that you have to sort of reprioritize how you practice and how you deal with the business mm-hmm. side and how you, you know, it becomes way more about quality over quantity.
Sort of switch gears here. Something that I don't think any of us predicted growing up is social media,
yeah.
this need to have a digital presence, have a website,
yeah.
web.com, built this fantastic website for you, because
yeah.
that's a thing that matters now
yeah.
as you're talking about your business
yeah.
and being an entrepreneur. How much do you know about that world, and how helpful was it to have someone like web.com come in and go?
I know nothing about that
yeah.
world, so it's great to have someone like web.com.
Right.
That website is phenomenal, and it's been a great resource.
All right, Blayne, thank you so much for joining me, answering all my questions about what it is like to be an entrepreneur and a businessman as well as a golfer.
Yeah.
Learned a lot today, so thanks for joining us
yeah.
on Beyond the Links.
Thanks for having me.
The last good. Shoot, I was apparently leaning over and out
of my shot. Am I good just like sitting comfortably back in my chair like
they'll
this?
Tell you.
I'll just be like super chill.
Yeah, exactly.